Hi guys, welcome to the CA classroom. In today's episode, we're going to talk about journey of CA students. So CA is a very tough course, and all of you know that. Some people take multiple attempts and they stay there. It takes 5-10 years to clear, and some people get it all done in the first attempt. So I got some people on my show, and today we have a student, CA Neeraj. So what he has done, he has got a rank in all three levels of CA. Foundation, earlier CA CPT, there was no rank at that time, but he got 95%, which is equal to a rank. All India rank 16 in Inter and All India rank 41 in CA final. It is not easy to get a rank. So let's welcome Neeraj first on the show to see how he has got a rank, and we'll discuss with him about his approach towards exams. Welcome, Neeraj.
Hi, Karthik.
Hi, Neeraj. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. So happy to join with you on this day.
Really happy for your rank. And before that, I want to give a disclaimer to everybody, guys. So everybody who are going to come on the show, who cleared after 7-8 attempts or who got rank in the first attempt, none of them are my students. They're all my friends whom I know like through different sources. So I brought them here to share with you their journey. So it's going to be useful for you guys. So Neeraj, I'm going to leave it to you. So you're going to tell us how you got a rank and what advice would you want to give to your juniors who are now in foundation, inter and final students.
Yeah, sure. So the thing is to begin with, I'll start with how I got into this course in the first place.
Sure.
So it was my cousin brother who inspired me to join this course because he was so boasting about this course. It's the toughest course in the country right now. So I just at the time I had two options, engineering or to do this. Then I thought that I'll do something challenging. So that's how I got into this course. Okay. So first I started with my intern doing with MEC.
Okay.
So that's the state board where you learn maths, economics, commerce, the base thing. So then starting from there, so I'll start with the CA journey. So where it started. So so CPT, it was like I studied in Masterminds, Guntur. Yeah. Many of you will know.
Yeah, definitely.
Would have known about it. So they taught us the CA CPT classes right from the beginning of intermediate.
Okay. So that we got 11th and 12th.
Yeah, 11th and 12th. Yeah, right. Yeah. 11th and 12th. So we got an year and a half to complete our classes. So it was along with this intermediate or CPT classes. Okay. So before exams, we had some 3 or 4 months after our intermediate exams. Between the intermediate and CPT, we had 3 months where we attended revision exams and study hours. So that was quite helpful. So in CPT, it was my first attempt, and I secured 189 marks. At that time, there were no ranks really due to some issue in Gujarat. They had to reschedule the exam, so that's why they didn't release ranks.
But that's equal to a rank, yeah.
Yeah, that's equal to Air 6 if in terms of rank.
Super.
So that's how. So from then, so later on, I moved to IPCC. See, the thing is, so I started even before the results. Before the results were declared for CPT.
Okay.
So they call it. I did IPCC also in Masterminds.
Yeah.
So it was pre-results batch. Yeah. It was a pre-results batch. So I had to start. I had to start before the release of CPT results. So like that, I had 1 month of time before the exams. So my classes started from there. So I had 10 months before my exam, CIPCC. So it was a scheduled thing over there. They'll teach you for 6 months and then study hours for 3 months. Super. So the thing is, I'd like to emphasize that in our course, the import you can't let it go away with this revision classes and study, as they're really, really important wherever you are, wherever institute you go. you shouldn't miss this revision classes. They really play an important role in securing a rank, I would say.
So basically, revision is very important. Like once you finish studying,
revision exams are really important. It's like a warm-up game before you go for the final match.
Got it.
So without revision exams and all, please don't expect any rank, because they're really, really important. The way, because they give you an opportunity to assess yourself in terms of your writing skills or the time management.
So Neeraj, you did your articleship in one of the best firms in the country with Deloitte Chennai. So that is a good thing. And then you cleared your CA final also recently with a rank. Could you want like walk us through your articleship experience and how you managed studying with a big four?
I worked at Deloitte. So doing articleship in a big four and studies and managing classes is really a challenging task, I would say, because it is a challenging task wherever you go. Like even in medium firms, it is not that easy, in my opinion. But as far as my articleship is concerned, I didn't get a chance to go for that many classes, because for half of my articleship tenure, I was allocated to outstation audits. So I actually could, because I paid for offline CAP classes, and then I was posted in outstation audit. So I couldn't really get a chance to complete all my classes on time. On time, it's not on time. I couldn't complete them at all.
Okay.
So basically, I started preparing for final in my study leave. Right from the first day, I started preparing for final. So the books I referred, firstly, the thing is, we didn't have much guidance on what books to use, and because I don't have much seniors to guide me through. So then I thought that study material, we'll go with study material.
I see. Okay.
I started. While doing final and all, you'll have some a kind of feeling when seeing others, because they, your friends or colleagues may study some author books also. If you start preparing for from ISM, ISM is really good because you need not go for any other materials if you have gone through ISM.
Correct.
Yeah. So to start with, I went to Masterminds again for my CA final study hours. So it's basically, they won't teach you anything. It's just study hours. So you'll have a couple of tests a week to test your level of understanding of concepts.
Okay.
So that they'll give you a they'll pre-schedule every test, so that they'll give you a sort of an examination timetable, so you can study based on the timetable. But unfortunately, during this thing, COVID, the pandemic came, and we had to leave that place.
Okay.
And then I was on my own. So
okay, that was very hard. Correct.
So yeah. I just came back home. Now I'll have to, start from and then exams got postponed.
Correct.
So I don't have any, and it got postponed for four times, I guess.
Yeah.
It was really a setback for most of the students, because they couldn't concentrate on exam thing. But I should say it's a boon for me, because the thing is, when I started final, by March, I had completed my first revision only. So I had only 1 month left till my final exams. I was so scared, I was not that confident to attempt final. But this pandemic, I should say, it was really a boon for me. It gave me additional 5 or 6 months, but I couldn't use that properly. I have used 3 months, because I had to complete my articleship also in that time. Okay. So coming to the course materials, I've used mainly institute study material and RTPs and MTPs.
Okay.
For FR, I've used only institute study material and RTP and MTPs. For SFM, I learned the basics from Dinesh Jain, sir, but And in addition to that, I took Paduka's ready referencer for SFM. So that because it'll cover huge concepts, right? Way back from 90s and all.
That's
so
the same book have... I use for my CA final also.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Actually, it covered a lot of things. So, and I could actually solve some tricky questions in the exams also because of that material. There were some concepts like this coefficient of determination, which were not there in our curriculum, but they gave it in the exam. So I was able to do those sums in exam because of that material. I'd say. And then for law and audit, it's institute material. Super. Plus scanner of Pankaj Garg scanner.
Super.
I use that. And then for SEMB, it's only institute That's study super. Material. Elective, I chose this financial service and capital markets. And you know, there's no other alternative.
Yeah, no alternative than ISM, correct.
So then for DT, DT, yeah. So DT was a peculiar thing. DT, you know what I did? I took ISM Institute Study Material. Because I told you I had no guidance at all in the first place. So I started with ISM. Okay. DT by its nature is a vast syllabus because. If you don't know where to start and how much to study and where to end with, you will end up losing yourself because it's like an ocean DT. So the only mistake I did was studying ISM for DT. So then after this postponement, I was lucky enough to, I came across this revision classes of Banwar Borana sir. So
super.
I was unfortunate to leverage the use of YouTube actually. Nice. So okay. I took his revision classes. Lectures are really good. He covers like entire syllabus in 1.5 days. So okay. You know what to study and what's not much important. So in that way you can prepare. I scored really good marks, like 82 I scored in DT. Awesome. That was my highest marks, I guess. So that's the only good thing happened in my opinion. So then IDT, it's Institute Study Material. You need not go anywhere other than Institute Study Material.
Brilliant.
Because you can't simplify down to that level. Institute has simplified everything for you. You need not bother going anywhere else than Institute Study Material.
So you got a rank in all three levels, and we have students from different levels watching this. To get a rank is not easy, to be honest. So would you mind sharing three important tips for students they should follow, like three important points to get a rank for those who want a rank?
Okay, fine. The first thing I would say that you should end having things that distract you. You'll have to end. You'll have to say goodbye to them. The things you were so addicted to, be it your mobile phone, be it YouTube. Some people will see they'll get addicted to YouTube, Facebook, Insta, or whatever. But you will have to self-motivate yourself to get away with those things, YouTube or your mobile phones.
Social media, basically.
Firstly, I was so addicted to YouTube, I couldn't leave it even during the final exams. But then at the end, like a month before exams, I could what I did was I couldn't leave it, but I just dropped my phone in my cupboard and I took a basic phone. That's the only thing I can do. That's how I got rid of this distraction thing.
Okay.
And the second thing is, second thing in my opinion is get yourself around with as many serious guys as you know, just for 2 months or 3 months, that's enough. I don't want you to be a nerd for the rest of your life, but for this, until your exams, get yourself along with some serious guys, serious people who will help you study, clarify doubts. I would say that's the most important thing you will have, because as I told you earlier, it's about the environment you study in, because the course is such that you will get easily distracted. You'll lose your
motivation.
You know, you'll lose your interest very easily. So you'll have to get engaged. The third thing is revision exams. Revision exams and revisions and mock tests are really important, as I told you earlier, because without them you are not going anywhere. I would suggest you to take up either online or offline mock tests at least once. You'll have to take them up to see where you stand first. Maybe you may self-evaluate yourself by using institute's mock test papers, which will get released just before the exams. You may, if you are not prepared well enough, you can use institute's mock test papers to self-evaluate yourself, so that you'll know where you stand. I think that's the most important thing in CA students' career, the revision exams, I would say. So do as many revisions as possible, because theory subjects like law, audit, they really need thorough reading. Like you'll have to do at least 3-4 revisions before you get to the final thing. Because it's not like you understand the concept and you can go write the exams. Because it's all about jargons and technical terms. You'll have to code there. Yeah, because it will be, you know, final and IPCC, they award marks based on some keywords, if you know. So if there are such keywords in your paper, they'll award marks, or else they're going to put a zero in that. Even if you're conceptually good and without technical terms and jargon, you're not going to get good marks, I would say. Yeah.
So Neeraj, thank you so much.
That's it.
Thank you so much for giving your inputs for students. And congrats again on your rank.
Yeah, Karthik.
All the very best.
Yeah, thanks a lot. Thank you. Karthik.